Welcome back to the channel where we make the switch to Google Analytics 4. And today we're going to talk about how to connect the GA4 account to your Google Search Console. And we're also going to quick go over the basics of Google Search Console. Maybe you do not have ever been inside there. You do not have it hooked up yet, but it's a quick link and conversion if you already have Google Search Console. It's an extra step if you don't have it. You have to create a Google Search Console account. So Google Search Console is another Google product that works really with GA4. It also works with Google Ads, and it allows you to take a look at your website, see the number of clicks that your website got from organic traffic, see the search terms, you can see your total impressions, and then the different queries that people saw in their Google feeds, and also what they actually clicked on. So if you really want to improve your SEO traffic and your organic traffic, going inside your Google Search Console report is definitely a big help and highly recommended. But today we're going to talk about how to connect that up. Now, Google Search Console can monitor your organic search traffic. You can track your positional rankings. You can monitor your link reports. You can also do a manual crawl of the website if you make changes. So if you don't want Google, wait until Google finds that you've made changes to your website. You can go into Google Search Console, do a manual crawl, and then that way you'll start ranking for those changes that you made to your website. So it's definitely important to know how to do a manual crawl inside Google Search Console. If you have not done that, or if you make a lot of changes to your website, that is another recommendation. Now, to actually connect your GA4 account to Search Console, you want to be in GA4 and you want to be on the home screen. And from the home screen, you're going to hit the admin button, which is that gear button at the bottom of the screen. That is going to bring you to product links. And in another video recently, we showed you how to connect to Google Ads. If you haven't connected to Google Ads, I'd recommend watching that video. But you can connect to your Google Search Console. So just by clicking on that link, that will bring up the links that are available for your Google Search Console. And it looks like this. It says the console property name, property type, if it's a web or if it's an app, the web stream, and then the date that it was linked. Now, this shows an example of one that is already connected to the Search Console. If you click on that button, nothing's there, then you'll want to click the link button that is blue. And then if you already have your Search Console connected to that email address, it will show up. Now, the one thing that you want to learn if you're new to the digital marketing in the Google space and you're using all the different products is you want to use the same email. You want to use the same email for Google Ads, Google Search Console, Google Analytics. That will allow you to add users, delete loot users, set up different property levels, and then add Google Search Console and Google Ads to your GA4 account. So make sure to use the same email. And also, inside Google Search Console, you can take a look at your website vitals, things like your good web links, poor web links. You can see your site index. You can see which links are getting clicks to them. So it does allow for a very comprehensive analysis of your website. And if you're more in charge of the marketing and you have somebody that's in charge of the your webmaster probably already has Google Search Console already hooked up. What you're going to be looking for as a marketer is your organic traffic, and then looking at your search queries. And then whenever Google does updates to their algorithms, you can see if your organic traffic is going up or down, and if your clicks are going up or down. And you can also break out your clicks by branded and non-branded search terms. Branded search terms are people that know you and know your name already, and non-branded search terms are people that don't know your search terms and they're searching for more generic terms. So definitely make sure to take a look at that in Google Search Console. So that is a look at how to connect GA4 to Google Search Console. If you do not have a Search Console account, make sure to start one up. If you already have one, then connect it to Search Console, get the data streams going, and then monitor your Search Console for monthly clicks, your impressions, and then definitely take a look at your search queries, see what's driving traffic and what's not driving traffic to Google search traffic and your website. That is a look as we continue to make the switch to GA4.